applications of Pascal's law. The first application is hydraulic lift. Hydraulic lift is an application of Pascal's law. It is used to lift heavy objects. It is a force multiplier. Let us be say that, see the diagram. So here there is a pistons, two pistons with the cylinder 1 and cylinder 2. Here it is a cylinder 1, this is a cylinder 2. According to this, here by seeing the picture itself, you can clearly see that this area is smaller, this area is bigger. Okay, so when the small force is given, it will lift the heavy load. So that's why we can say that the hydraulic lift is a force multiplier. This will work on the principle of Pascal's law. What is the Pascal's law? Pascal's law states that the pressure exerted at any point in the enclosed liquid is transmitted equally in all directions. That means the pressure at piston 1 is equal to pressure at piston 2. So that is pressure at piston 2 is F by A, capital F by area is capital A. Then the pressure at this point is F by A. If you bring this A this side, the force on the piston 2 is F by AA. Since this capital A is greater than small a, capital A is greater than small a, so this value will be bigger value, then the force is also become multiplied. So very simple concept. According to Pascal's law, the pressure is equal. Since here the area is smaller, here the area is bigger. Hence the force is given that if the area increases, correspondingly the pressure maintained constant. Here the pressure is maintained constant. In order to maintain the pressure equal, so in order to maintain this P value equal, if the F value increases, means that the A values also increase correspondingly. So that is the thing they are used here. So F by A is equal to small F by A. This is applied force area. This is a load force, that area. So these things are used in hydraulic lift, is used in heavy industries and lifting a heavy objects. Now the next application is hydraulic brake. Hydraulic brake is used in automobiles or based on the principle of Pascal's law for the transmission of pressure in a liquid. Here the hydraulic brake consists of tube T containing a brake oil. So this is a tube T shaped, you know? So there is a brake oil is there. One end of this tube is connected to master cylinder fitted with the piston P. So this is a master cylinder piston P where we are giving the brake pedal. Okay, the piston P is attached to the brake pedal through the lever system. Piston P is attached to the brake pedal through the lever. Here it is a lever system, it will attach. The other end of the tube is connected to a wheel cylinder having two pistons. The other end will be connected to the two pistons with the wheel cylinder. There will be a piston P1 and P2 connected along with the brake shoes S1 and S2. There will be a brake shoe. This is a wheel. Okay. Here also the liquid will be there. When the pedal is pressed, its lever system pushes the piston to the master. So what will happen? The pressure is given here. According to the Pascal's law, the pressure will be distributed equally in all directions. Hence here the area is smaller, here the area is bigger, the pressure will be increased. By giving a less force, the brake shoes will be attracted, it will be contact more closely with the wheel. Due to the friction with the brake shoe and the wheel, the speed of the wheel will be decreased. So very simple, in this liquid the Pascal's law is obeyed. When the pedal is released, this spring will pulls the brake shoes away from the rim. The piston in the both the cylinders moves towards a normal position and the oil is forced back to the master cylinder. Again, when it is pressured, means what will happen? All the liquid will be come here. When it is released, what will happen? The spring will be released, means the liquid again goes to the master cylinder for the further application of brake. So this is the hydraulic brake working system. So the two important applications of Pascal's law is hydraulic lift and hydraulic brake.